What is the job market like for new grads? Are there opportunities for employment?
Just reflecting back to last year compared to this year, I think that it is safe to say that there are more jobs than PAs. So I don't know if this is accurate statistically, but based on the opportunities I saw being a new grad and applying to positions last year compared to this year, I feel like more supervising physicians are aware of the PA role and want to hire more PAs. I think that PAs have made a huge impact during the pandemic, which really advocated for our role. And as a result, we have more docs who want PAs on board to avoid burnout, share the workload, and kind of take care of the patient cases and the workload post-pandemic, if we're there yet. So I think that it has really, the pandemic, one of the silver linings is that it has helped advocate for the PA role. PAs have really proven their impact in patient care and in Canadian healthcare system throughout the past couple of years. And I think the future is bright for PA. So I don't think that pre-PAs or PA students have to worry too much about employment opportunities. And one thing that one of the supervising physicians I work with said is, if there isn't an opportunity, you can create an opportunity. You can, you know, PAs have made made an impact in patient care, and if there's an opportunity for you to create a new job, then we have trailblazers like yourself and other mentors to reach out to make that happen, and that's also an option.
So can you tell us a little bit more about what it was like to find a job after graduation?
Yeah, so it was definitely a very a great learning experience. So there were a lot of job opportunities outside Career Start, which is the program that Ontario government provides to help the new grads transition into a job. So they cover half of the salary for the first year for the Southern PAs, and then for PAs who work up north in the underserved areas, it could also be for the first 2 years of their practice. And the employer would cover the other half of it. So there were external jobs that were being posted earlier on, and then there were also the Career Start grant positions. So the process was everyone had a different approach. I tried to keep my options open, and that was in terms of specialty as well. I always knew I wanted to work in ortho, but I still kept my options open and applied to family medicine and emergency medicine. I found the interview process to be very rewarding because you learn a lot about yourself as you speak about yourself to employers. And also learn about the understanding of the PA role with all these different supervising docs and different specialties. So after that, I did a lot of self-reflection to see what specialty would be best for me to start off, and I landed in emergency medicine, which funnily enough is not a specialty I thought I would start off in, but I'm very grateful for, especially for all the learning I have gotten in the last few months.
What would your general advice be for approach to looking for employment after PA school?
Yeah, crazy to think that last year this time I was going through the same process, and I did a lot of self-reflection. I think that's my key takeaway from that process. So lots of self-reflection in terms of where you see yourself down the line, whether it's like, you know, a few years down the line, and looking at your career as a whole. Lots of pressure to think about it, but you want to see what specialties interest you, what will give you a good foundation, what type of environment you want to work in, whether it's hospital or a clinic, outpatient clinic environment. The number of team members you want to work with. So for example, a clinic, you'll have fewer docs, but it's a bit more niche. And then in a hospital, there's more docs, and it's a bit more broad. But then for some reason, I thought that that would be kind of like your, there's a lot of people and it's broad, but then it's a big family basically. So we all work together. So reflect on what you want in terms of the team you work with, the environment, the specialty, as well as even the geographic location, and what you want career-wise. And I think all those factors will point you in the right direction in terms of choosing a position. And one last tip I would say is keeping your options open. By keep your options open, I mean that don't limit yourself at an early stage when you're applying for jobs. So for me personally, I always knew ortho was on the list for me because of my background in kinesiology, but I always had this question in the back of my mind if I should consider general medicine to start off. and build a strong foundation in that to kickstart my PA career. So I did apply to family medicine and emergency medicine, which was not something that I thought of earlier. But based on my reflection, I was like, okay, so if I want to keep my options open and kind of have that background knowledge and that opportunity to consolidate what I learned in PA school right after graduating, then it will help me down the line, even if I transition into specialty care.